This is the first film in our series about industrial lubricants. Learn the very basics of what they are and what they do.
Lubricants are used all around the world. Everything in motion needs a lubricant. The lubricant market in general is around 40 million tons globally. And about 45% of that volume is industrial oils. Industrial lubricants are divided in several groups. The main group is the power transmitting hydraulic fluids. And they are used to transmit pressure, oil pressure, into a linear motion, a circular motion, or a reciprocating motion. For metalworking fluid, you have to divide that into the oils that are used as a cutting oil, so to take away chips or pieces of material, or the forming oils that are used to lubricate a forming process, so to bend something. The grease part of the total volume of lubricants is around 3-4%. And the grease is a niche market. It's a very typical market because you transfer the oil into a consistency which stay on one place. While the oil is fluid, the oil has or the grease has a consistency. So you basically add a thickener to the oil, like it works like a sponge, that holds the oil in the sponge all the time. So the oil is kept in a specific place. Well, viscosity is, I guess, one of the most important characteristics of a lubricant. And the viscosity is determined by the application, so the size and the pressure, the power, the load. A typical high viscosity oil could be, for instance, in gear oil for heavy duty applications like with gearboxes in windmills or heavy industrial gearboxes. And low viscosity oils is oil where you need a lot of motion, for instance, an honing oil where you have to flush away all the time the metal chips. So it's used as a coolant and a transport mean to get rid of the particles. You can imagine if there is a high load, so heavy equipment, so you need a strong, thick oil film to carry the load. If you have a high revolution, you need very low viscous, thin oil. Pain points can be related to sustainability. We are looking more to sustainable oils. You have to look at compatibility with materials. We want longer lifetime of oil, so that means we have to look into the use of the oil, the accumulation of contaminants, temperatures, thermal stability, oxidation stability, how you can improve that. Well, for total cost of the oil for a user is first based on the purchase of the oil, but it's also the oil change of the machine or equipment. So that means you have to shut it down. It depends on the installation, how much time and cost will be involved in that. So you have to change the oil and you have to dispose the new oil or the used oil. So there will be cost involved as well. And it depends on the possibilities you have to dispose the oil. So can you have somebody collect the oil, or do you have to ship it to some place?
These were the basics about industrial lubrication. In the next film, we'll talk about the oil value chain and the different application areas for industrial lubricants.